Hello guys! Today I'm going to be doing a cover of Death of a Bachelor, and I'm going to be doing it on my little baritone, which I finally made a little strappy for. Yay! So yeah, I'm going to be doing a cover. After the cover, I will probably, well, I'm going to be talking for a little bit, so if you want to stick around and listen to that, you can, otherwise that's okay. Yeah. Alright, so I'm going to get started. Shadows on my face, and people have told me I don't look the same. Maybe I lost weight, or I'm playing hooky. But the best of the best, put my heart on my chest so you can see it too. I'm walking the long road, watching the sky fall. Ladies in your dress tingles my neck. How do I live the death of a bachelor? Oh, letting the waterfall, the death of a bachelor. Oh, seems so fitting for happier after. Ooh, how could I have some more? A lifetime of laughter at the expense of the death of a like my heart is going to burst. I'm alone at a table for two, and I just want to be served. And when you think of me, am I the best you ever had? Just share one more drink with me and smile even though you're sad. I'm walking the long road, watching the sky fall. The lace in your dress tangles my neck. How do I live the death of a bachelor? Oh, letting the water fall, the death of a bachelor. Oh, seems so fitting for happily after. Ooh, how could I ask some more? A lifetime of laughter at the expense of the death of a I'm so sorry I did that. Yeah, so that was my cover of Death of a Bachelor. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I don't know. yeah, I had a lot of fun making it, so I hope you guys had a lot of fun watching it. I wanted to cover this song a lot sooner. I kind of got sick though, so yeah. I swear, it's every time that I want to make a cover or a video or something that I just happen to come down with a cold. I'm like, alright, time to make a video, and my body's like, no, it's not. I'm like, why not? And my body's like, you have a cold. And I'm like, no, I don't. And it's like, you sure? And I'm like, oh no. I wanted to make a cover of the song because I've been on YouTube over a year now, and I thought Death of a Bachelor was really fitting of that because Panic at the Disco found me at just the right time again. Me and Panic at the Disco had a bit of a disconnection for a while, and then I bounced back like that. And that was due to a lot of things. I guess to like start it off, it was a year ago when I started YouTube, I had also started college, and things just weren't going as I planned them to. college was a very interesting time for me, so to say. I just couldn't, I don't know. There was a lot of stuff going wrong. And I guess it starts off with the fact that like, in all my art classes, it felt like everybody had already taken, like, at least 3 to 7 years of art classes beforehand. I was here. I'd never taken an art class before, and I was like, what am I doing? What is going on? I didn't understand what the teacher was talking about. I didn't understand the techniques they were talking about. I didn't understand the materials we were using. I was so lost. I felt so behind, and I just started. Which is crazy. Yeah, and so I kept struggling with it, and I was like, I got to a point where I was kind of like, why am I doing this? Why am I trying to do this? And Panic at the Disco at the time had, it was October, and Panic at the Disco had released their music video for Emperor's New Clothes, and I remember watching it, and I was just like, oh my god, this video is amazing. The music is so great. The visuals were incredible. And I was like, I want to make something like that. I want to make something that is so compelling. Because I remember watching it and just, I watched it the first time. And all I could think was like, oh, okay, that was really cool. And then I kind of like, okay. And then I went on, and the next day I was like, I'm going to watch it again. So I watched it again. And I was like, oh, yeah, that's cool. And then I kept doing that. I kept coming back to the video. And every time I'd fall more and more in love with it. And I was just like, I want to make something that people will be like, they have to come back to it. Because they're like, wow, that's so cool. And so that's why I was like, okay, I have to do all this drawing basic stuff in order to, so that one day I can get on the computer, put everything together, draw stuff into little motions and whatnot, so that maybe one day somebody will be like, hey, that's kind of cool. And then they'll come back to me and be like, hey, that's still cool. And then they'll come back to me and be like, oh my god, what am I saying? Yeah, I just want to make something that's really cool. And Panic at the Disco kind of reminded me about that. They reminded me why I was doing this. Since that song is on their Death of a Bachelor album, I kind of wanted to do a song for Death of a Bachelor. You know, it was a theme. It was the yeah. I'm really proud of myself making it this far, because I remember when I started making YouTube videos, there was just a bit of a struggle for me. I remember I just wanted to make videos whenever I wanted to make them. And they're going to be whatever I wanted them to be about. And that was good for me. And then I got to a point where I was making videos and I realized that it wasn't just like my family and friends watching me anymore. It was like other people that I had no idea who they were watching me. And I was like, oh, crap. What if they don't like me? It got to this little point in the back of my brain where it was like, what if they don't like me? And that was around, I don't know, January, for so to say, that I just kind of got into a little, and I didn't know what to make. I still wanted to make stuff, but I didn't know what to make anymore, because I wanted to please people now. I wanted to please everybody else but myself when I'm making the videos. I was like, okay, well, I gotta make something that they find entertaining. I gotta do something that they're gonna think is funny or something. And so for a while there, my videos weren't exactly, I wasn't making as many, and they weren't exactly very good. I don't think they were very good. And then, around April, May, when I had started, well, May, June. Was it? Wait. No, it was April, May. And, we had started to make, our animation in my 3D class. And that was the Life on Mars video. And I remember making it, and I had no intention of ever putting it on YouTube. I was just going to make it and, you know, show it to the class, and that was going to be the end of it. And I remember getting done with it, and I loved the video. I mean, it wasn't great, you know? It could definitely be improved, and I probably will improve it in the future, but it's not. It was something I had a lot of fun making, and I was like, you know, I'll put it on my YouTube channel because it would be something good to be able to look back on one day when I'm better at animating and can actually do stuff better. To look back and be like, this is what you started off doing, and look at you now. So I was like, I'll put it up. Why not? So I put it up, and you guys responded so well to it. And I was like, I didn't make it to show off or to put up as like something for you guys to be like, oh yeah, I wanted to make it for me, for class. And I remember making it, and it was so that I could prove to myself that I could make a 3-minute Because I remember the limit was like 2 minutes, and I was like, I'm going to make it through. Just to prove to myself that I could, and I did. And I was proud of it. And so after that, it finally hit me. What should have hit me like a while ago was that it doesn't matter what I put up, as long as I like it. Because if I like it, then there's bound to be at least one person who's going to be like, oh yeah, that's kind of cool. You know? And if not, and if people don't like it, then they can click away, you know? They don't have to watch your stuff. They'll probably just think of you for like 2 seconds and then that's it. And I was like, I could live with that. I could live with somebody having a negative thought about me. You know what? I don't care. I got to a point where I was just like, you can't please everybody, so at least please yourself. So then, I just started making videos again for myself. And what I realized is that whenever I'm making videos, it feels like anything that's bothering me or anything that's worrying me kind of just slips away. I kind of forget why I was having a bad day or why I was mad or something. So, yeah, I wanted to make this video for that reason. Like, to acknowledge the fact that I made it this far. And to kind of just give myself the boost to keep going and just, I wanted to make something. So, that was my video. This is my thing. I hope you guys are feeling okay. And if you feel like maybe you're not doing something the way you're supposed to be, or maybe you're not doing something that everybody else likes, that's okay. You know, if you're having fun doing it, or yeah, if you're having fun doing it and it makes you happy, then why not? You know, I don't see a reason why it could be bad. Maybe it doesn't apply to everything. Ooh, maybe it doesn't apply to everything. Most things. If it makes you happy, why would you stop doing it? Unless, of course, it's like murder or something. Then, you know, you might want to cut that out. Sorry, this is becoming a really... I'm losing the point of what I was trying to say. Just do what makes you happy. Yeah, okay. Bye, guys.